What's up, Tube? We are back. It's main event time. I haven't said this in a while, but yeah, main event time, guys. Intercontinental title up for grabs. How ironic is this, a rematch from the New Year's Evolution, the very first one the EXE got it, had that record for about 86 days as European champion, which is a pretty long run for. But Kensou, these two survived one hell of a punishment as Goku Black, and of course EXE and Goku Black had one hell of a performance in that False Count Anywhere match at EXE. I love the strategy. But meanwhile, Kensou survived a whole lot of beat-ups from being burned and being burned from K-Dash's flames, fire punches, and it was just a lethal flaming fight and a lot of blood being spat out from him. K-Dash was sent to the infirmary, sent to the hospital. But K-Dash finally K-Dash, thanks to Rayne's interference and really helping out Kensou. Could this be a sign of a face turn? We don't know about Rayne's antics, what happened at this past March. But right here we want to focus on the now, and that's the Intercontinental title on the line. Of course, again, what a night we had at Raleigh, North Carolina. It was a bloodbath in Raleigh, North Carolina. It was one hell of a. These two, in my opinion, stole the show. And of course, probably had the best rating. But these two are going to compete for the one of the second biggest prizes of this company. And of course, in my opinion, one of the most prestigious titles in this brand split is the Intercontinental Championship, which is a good pickup to the show for the Land of Extreme. And there we go. Who becomes Intercontinental Champ? Well, Kensou's gonna get his title match against his good buddy EXE. These two are huge baby faces, but we'll see what these two can bring. Big main event underway. EXE's had that strong defense. It really thinks that. Kensou's getting all prepared, but he has Steve. Here we go. Title match underway. And we'll see next week. Season finale is coming up. We'll see Kensou. We'll see Goku Black in a rematch clause, and EXE just making quick work here. And a guts to, oh my god, right in the face of Kensou, damn. Jesus, and EXE with a guts to punch to the face. EXE on the top ropes, again. As he get ready for round two, and so Kensou got a little bit of a nice little shot, but there was nobody home there. First blow, but EXE with a massive, oh my god. And a gutsal punch, but nobody holding a cybersword uppercut knocks down Kensou. A little bit of revenge, payback from last few years from the first New Year's Evolution. And remember, EXE did lose that the ECW title to Kensou years ago. But now here, Kensou getting his ass kicked, and obviously, yeah, both guys are not 100% after their beatdowns, but they survived one hell of a punishment. But I'm sure Goku Black's probably gonna get a rematch clause next week, and. Yeah, well, no, EXE had a second title defense, but back-to-back title defenses coming up. As EXE was, he's saying the fact that Goku Black wants a title shot, but that was from Teddy DiBiase too. So we'll see. Of course, some people are asking about a rematch clause for Goku Black. It is true. It is in his contract. Yes, it is. According to his contract, yes, it is from Chun Li. So they'll get a rematch. So we'll see Goku Black and EXE one last time. Best of the rivalries, but obviously these two have shared history already the last all season long. These two have been going back and forth like these few months since they all of winter. They really kicked ass, and they told a good story in this one. But EXE and Kensou, as the main event comes to a close, very fast title defense. EXE just too damn strong. He's just so beefy now, and thanks to Rule Dynasty's help, really giving a boost up because they were delivering a lot of packages, of course. But Rhodes sent it was from Dr. Light himself. He's a huge fan of EXE, and of course he's the one that partially created Mega Man. But Dr. Light stopped on by and gave EXE that boost, which I think that makes sense in accordance to the World Dynasty, because that's what's delivered to EXE. But he loved it. EXE was looking better than ever. His guts old punch is pretty nasty, and his cybersword uppercut showing what he can do. We don't see people go like this. Like die easily from that cyber sword uppercut these days, so rare to see it. But Kensou just got destroyed, and I'm sure EXE will be able to defend that Intercontinental title for a long time. But a successful title defense, good job EXE. Kensou, meanwhile, no shame losing tonight, even though he just got bodied. And thanks, if it weren't for Rayne, Kensou would be bleeding right now. But I think that's the only thing I can say about Kensou. He got lucky there. to be honest, like, Kensou got lucky with his new girlfriend, you know, trying to protect her new lover. But obviously, we'll be heading to Louisiana for the finale, so it's going to be pretty cool to have a little Louisiana fest. Our home court advantage for Rayne, because she actually is from Louisiana, residing in Louisiana, actually, so we'll be heading to home in Baton Rouge, coming up for Louisiana. That's where they ended off in the Bayou. So we're heading to the Bayou, folks. We're heading down to the swamps, heading to the Bayou for ECW's finale. So we'll see you guys there. But also, yeah, before I go, actually, of course, leave a like, subscribe if you're new, and hit the notification bell. Very important. And of course, you guys check out the merch store. We have a new merch store dropping in. Is of course, we look forward to. Hopefully, you guys will enjoy to buy some merch. The new Raw, the image of Raw shirts, tank top, and also the zips and the new zippers and the. The zip hoodies and also the long sleeve shirts are now available. It'll be the first link down below for the if you want to check out the merch store. You know, we have a merch store. Thank you guys, of course, shout out to people over there on Twitch for your support and hope that helps us out every single time. And buy merch, very important. And we, of course, head to the end. Let's just talk about the Elimination Chamber. This will be our first Elimination Chamber since 2006. Since the Extreme Elimination Chamber. So we're now in that out of the way. We have some room to discuss about the Elimination Chamber. We have our six guys. Chun-Li has already issued the challenges. Has already issued the qualified matches. If you guys have seen the qualified matches on Extreme Saturday and on the main roster, we have our top six. We have, because if you haven't seen Victory, All start with Kirby and DK. Donkey Kong got the win over Kirby. This is a huge win for DK. So it'll be Donkey Kong first. Shin Kazuma, who qualified against Kenzo and just burned the living piss out of him before the pay-per-view. I guess someone got him a Phoenix down. So thankfully, I'm sure Kenzo will get another Phoenix down later tonight. We have Shin Kazuma in there. We have Spider-Man, who just qualified in at the most Victory pay-per-view, which was over Ted DiBiase, like I said. After DiBiase got hit in the monitor right in the head. That's gonna hurt if you saw that spot. That was nasty. Right in the head right in the monitor too. That was on that steel cage. I don't know why there's a monitor there in the first place. But Spider-Man will have a shot. Spidey's gonna be heading to the main event picture, which is crazy. We're heading to Louisiana for Raw. Sorry, for ECW. I keep saying Raw because I have Raw stuck in my head now. Let's see, we picked up Kratos, who qualified in that Fatal 4-Way, which is on Extreme Saturday. So Kratos, who is a legend on TK's show, now he's part of this one as well. Terry Bogard, of course, who challenged him, who will get a rematch. He used his claws at the Elimination Chamber, and the champ himself, which obviously makes sense. Lord Brevin, the ECW title will be defended inside the X for the first time since 2006, which is one of the god-awful pay-per-views, December to Dismember. The first Extreme Elimination Chamber will be taking place. So, this will be a very interesting finale. Our first Elimination Chamber in Mugen history. We don't see it happen, but it's gonna be punishing steel. It's steel meeting skin. It's gonna be crazy and nasty, nasty main event. And I'm sure all six guys are gonna give it their all. We're gonna start from one guy to two guys to three. So basically, we'll go from singles to tag team to 4v4. So, oh, sorry, 3v3. My bad, 3v3, which is gonna be a pretty intense. That will lead to elimination. So it's gonna build up to all the guys, and then we'll have elimination. So basically, we'll have like five rounds in Elimination Chamber, I guess you could say, because it's gonna be like from singles. Then doubles, then triples, and then it goes to elimination style. They'll go backwards. So, it could be very strange. I'm sure you guys will understand when we get to the finale in Louisiana. It's going to be a very, very. It's a battle of the Bayou in this Extreme Elimination Chamber. So anyone who's from Louisiana or near down south of the swamps, it's going to be a battle of the Bayou in the Elimination Chamber, no doubt about it. And as your plays. Hope you guys, again, leave a like if you guys enjoyed. Merch store has dropped early in April, and we're ready to start off strong. And the finale is next week, guys. We are heading to the Bayou for ECW. Azure Blaze. Blaze! always on. And we'll see you next time. See you at the finale, everybody.
Can't wait for the Elimination Chamber, though.